Hello everyone, today we are going to talk about WiMAX, stands for Worldwide Interoperability for Microwave Access, and it is a technology for point-to-point and point-to-multipoint wireless connection. WiMAX technology is a wireless broadband communications technology based on IEEE 802.16 standard, providing high-speed data over a wide area. It was introduced in 2001. WiMAX wireless microwave access technology can provide 4G levels of broadband wireless access for both mobile and fixed applications. It was considered a prime candidate for 4G mobile networks over CDMA, GSM, and HSPA. Being a part of 4G wireless communication technology, WiMAX has surpassed 30-meter wireless range of a traditional Wi-Fi local area network, offering a metropolitan area network with a signal radius of about 50 km. WiMAX was originally proposed as a wireless alternative to wired internet access, DSL or cable at the time, particularly in areas that are difficult for wired infrastructure to reach and the ability to overcome the physical limitations of traditional wired infrastructure. WiMAX works similar to Wi-Fi but at higher speeds over greater distances. WiMAX provide data transfer rates of up to 75 megabits per second, which was quite superior to conventional cable modems and DSL connections. WiMAX operates over radio waves on a tower receiver model. A single WiMAX tower can provide coverage over about 8,000 square kilometers and also connect to the other towers via a line of sight microwave link to expand coverage further. Line of sight communication means when there is no signal obstruction between transmitter and receiver. Non-line of sight communication is also possible even when there is a signal obstruction between transmitter and receiver. Signal arrives at the receiver after going through many reflections in between. WiMAX technology is proficient to meet the needs of a large variety of users, from those in developed nations who want to install a new high-speed data network very cheaply without the cost and time required to install a wired network, to those in rural areas who need fast access where wired solution may not be possible because of the distances and costs involved, effectively providing WiMAX broadband. Additionally, it is being used for mobile applications, providing high-speed data to users on the move. WiMAX broadband technology uses some key technologies to enable it to provide high-speed data rates. OFDM, Orthogonal Frequency Division Multiplexing. OFDM has been incorporated into WiMAX technology to enable it to provide high-speed data without the selective fading and other issues of other forms of signal format. MIMO, Multiple Input, Multiple Output. WiMAX technology makes the use of multipath transmission using MIMO. By utilizing the multiple signal paths that exist, the use of MIMO either enables operation with lower signal strength levels or allows for higher data rates. WiMAX and Wi-Fi are complementary. While WiMAX is a broadband connection to the internet at service quality, Wi-Fi is a wireless local area network. Duplexing modes in Wi-Fi. Duplexing means the way downlink and uplink data is arranged in a two-way wireless transmission. Downlink carries information from a base station to subscriber station. Downlink is also known as a forward link. Uplink carries information from subscriber station to base station. It is also called reverse link. There are two types of duplexing modes, FDD and TDD. Frequency division duplex requires two distinct channels for transmitting downlink subframe and uplink subframe at the same time slot. FDD is commonly used in 2G and 3G mobile networks. WiMAX supports full duplex FDD and half duplex FDD. FDD is inefficient for handling asymmetric data services. Time division duplex is another duplexing mode that requires only one channel for transmitting downlink and uplink subframes at two distinct time slots. TDD therefore has higher spectral efficiency than FDD. Moreover, using TDD, downlink to uplink ratio can be adjusted dynamically. TDD can flexibly handle both symmetric and asymmetric broadband traffic. Most WiMAX implementations use TDD. The reasons are TDD use half of FDD spectrum, which saves the bandwidth. TDD system is less complex and thus cheaper. Coming to an end, WiMAX has been replaced by LTE, but is still being used in some parts of the world. Developing countries are using this technology. Developed countries are already moved on to 5G networks. Alright, so this wraps up today's video. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe.